Today, we're talking about item synergy, and more specifically about the first item combination that really allows this level of synergy. Specifically, Gem of Isolation and Runeforge Hammer, who both will see a buff tomorrow and will therefore be stronger but also work at the same time. Now, I was going to make a video where I just talk about how it's a little better and it can be beneficial in specific situations, but after actually going through all this stuff, I was pretty surprised myself. You will see in the background footage here that the damage dealt with only Vampiric Shroud, Pen Boots, and Gem of Isolation is actually higher on level 10 against a level 1 Odin bot than the one dealt with the same build but replacing Gem of Isolation with Rod of Tahuti. Now, the damage value for Rod of Tahuti in this case was 434, whereas Gem of Isolation dealt 437. To get that in a little more context, obviously, Rod of Tahuti works better when you have more power items, but I just wanted to have an item that provides you significantly more power than Gem of Isolation for a higher price as well and see how they compare against each other. I tried out the whole thing with two builds that actually have basically full build again. This scenario kept that one last slot for either Rod of Tahuti or Gem of Isolation. Turns out even then, the damage difference is only ever so slightly in favor of Rod of Tahuti, which comes in with 740 damage, whereas with the Gem of Isolation and a slow, you deal 726 damage. To make this a little more clear here, what was used here was Runeforged Hammer on the Chark, so the enemy was slowed, which he would have also been by Gem of Isolation, but then you have to factor in that you use other abilities beforehand in order to slow him, blah, 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 blah. So I wanted to make it simple. So as long as somebody on your team has Runeforged Hammer and it's close to an enemy, the damage difference between Gem of Isolation in its buffed form and Rod of Tahuti is pretty much non-existent. The benefit of Gem of Isolation here is obviously that the enemy gets slowed, which is obviously helpful for your team as well, and also that the buff that you get from the Runeforged Hammer will proc because of it. So as long as your ally is close, he doesn't even need to use his own slowing abilities. Your Gem of Isolation will allow you to deal as much or sometimes even more or a little less damage than Rod of Tahuti for a cheaper price and with the addition of extra health and extra mana, which is on the item, whereas you lose some MP5, which no one really cares about. The implications of this are, in my opinion, pretty freaking crazy. Obviously, what you have to keep in mind here is that Rod of Tahuti increases your magical power. That means it doesn't increase the base damage of any ability, simply because it only works into the scaling. The combination of Runeforged Hammer and Gem of Isolation allows you to get bonus damage no matter what kind of source it is. It is the extra damage on both the base damage and the scaling, as well as basic attacks. So literally everything is amplified. And with that now being 15%, it's actually pretty ridiculous. I didn't realize how much it would be at first, but given that it's on the same level as the strongest single power item in the game for mages, it's very clear that we're going to see a lot more of this item as soon as people pick up on this. I also want to make clear that this is not the only extra damage you're getting. Obviously, the player getting that item will also deal more damage, and everyone else hitting that target will also deal more damage. And you still get the additional slow, allowing you to set up if you get Gem of Isolation. As such, the combination of Gem of Isolation on your mid laner and Runeforged Hammer on your solo laner is incredibly strong. Now, other roles can obviously get this as well, but especially in this particular scenario, I felt like it's worth pointing out. And the problem with this is obviously you need to coordinate this with your team. You need to make it clear that you want to go for this item, that you want to go for this combination, but that's where the item synergy comes in. So far, when you were building, you were mostly building for yourself unless you support. Obviously, there are some team-oriented items like anti-heal or just any kind of aura item that, for example, protection reduction items that also work for your allies. But it's rarely the case that you're actually building these items for your allies more than yourself. And they don't need to have any items that complement those items in order for them to be effective. Obviously, if your ally gets Titan's Bane and you get Executioner, it's a little bit disadvantageous, but it doesn't really matter much in the end. With Gem of Isolation and Runeforged Hammer in the current state, it is actually very beneficial and basically crucial to get both at the same time. As such, I would like to once again stress how much stronger Runeforged Hammer is now. This pretty much applies for anyone. I could even imagine it being picked up on assassins, depending on how they can weave it into their build. We will see a lot more aggressive assassins builds now with the changes to Hydra's Lament and stuff like that. But I feel like Runeforged Hammer could actually show up on certain assassins, but especially on solo laners. Frostbound and Gem of Isolation both have the synergy with it, and I am more than certain that they can be picked up more across all lanes and actually work in the team's favor. I haven't done the numbers on that yet, but I could even imagine that potentially hunters with Frostbound Hammer could maybe be able to deal more damage than other hunters if there's someone nearby that also got Runeforged Hammer for them. So the aura helps them, whereas Frostbound Hammer is just generally a very annoying item for an enemy hunter to trade with. But due to that, you could actually get more damage than the enemy simply because it's 15% extra damage now. A value that sounds pretty crazy to me. And when you think about it, one of Amaterasu's strength in late game, aside of her movement speed aura and her crowd control effective ultimate, is that she can do an additional 10% damage to enemies or mark them so everyone does that kind of damage. That's basically what Runeforged Hammer is now, only that it is stronger and it will also be easier to apply as long as you get allies that get slow items or have natural slows in their kit. You can obviously combine the both as well. You can get it on Amaterasu, also as a slow in her ultimate, who can get Frostbound Hammer, and then get a mage with Gem of Isolation, and the enemies will constantly be slowed while taking more damage from Runeforged Hammer from every other source, as long as the warrior or whoever is using the item stays close to them. In conclusion, buy Gem of Isolation, buy Runeforged Hammer, buy Frostbound Hammer, and communicate it with your team, because those items are really, really good now in combination. Thank you guys for watching. See you all tomorrow. Duke Sloth, out.